Greetings, friends and volunteers of the Beacon. On behalf of the Board of Directors, staff, and especially us clients, I want to thank you for spending time to help make the best out of a challenging situation. I know that I sure do appreciate you being here.
Today, you will be working in the Day Center. While the Day Center is the most prominent program of the Beacon, there are three other programs that help restore dignity, self-respect, and hope to those on the street like me.
A clinic, giving care to basic health and psychiatric needs.
A legal aid program providing pro bono legal assistance to those who need it.
And a transitional program that helps women exiting the prison system become self-supported.
As a volunteer, you work in one of the following locations and may participate in similar duties as shown: laundry and shower services, kitchen, meal services, client greeting and hospitality.
That didn't look too hard, right? The desire to be helpful and the ability to offer a warm smile are the only skills you need prior to your volunteer task today.
When you get to your selected area, the director for that service will assign you a specific job and explain any specific procedures you will need to follow. If there are any special skills you need to complete your volunteer task, a Beacon staff member will work alongside you to help you master it.
If you have signed up as a Put Me Wherever You Need Me volunteer, you will be filling holes throughout the schedule as needed. This means you could possibly work in multiple locations throughout the Day Center. If this pertains to you, or you do not know what volunteer position you signed up for, please make sure that you get with a staff member after the video.
No matter where you signed up to work, we want to make sure you have the enjoyable and rewarding experience. With that in mind, there are a few items, safety precautions, and details you should be made aware of.
Please place your personal belongings in the lockers located directly behind you. Items in the Day Center can easily go missing.
Also, please note where the restrooms are. You should have seen them on your way in, but if not, they are located straight out of the training room door. If at any time during your volunteer shift you need to utilize these facilities, please get an access card from a Beacon staff member. This card will help you get through the door that separates the Day Center from our volunteer-only areas.
When in the Day Center, stay alert and aware. Safety is our number one priority. If at any time you see or hear anything that makes you uncomfortable, please let one of the Beacon staff members or security personnel know. We do not tolerate any abusive, inappropriate, or rude behavior, gestures, speech, or any actions by clients, staff, or volunteers.
From experience, I can tell you that most every client who sets foot in the Day Center is genuinely appreciative of your service. That being said, you might occasionally meet someone on a bad day. Please keep in mind that living on the streets is hard, it is a high-stress environment, and many of the people that you will serve today are dealing with personal issues ranging from substance abuse to mental health issues. And please be mindful of personal space. Never sneak up on a client, touch a client without their permission, or try to move any of their belongings. Never engage in an argument with the client. If a situation arises, be polite and ask the client to bring up any issues with one of our program managers.
Furthermore, for your safety, never give out money, favors, or additional services to a client above what is outlined in our program. Most clients that utilize the Day Center know these rules. However, there may be some clients that would try to test you to see what they can get away with, especially if you are a new volunteer. This is not acceptable behavior in the Day Center.
If you feel you are being harassed or being asked to do anything outside of the program guidelines, please let one of the Day Center staff members or security officers know immediately. In the event of a dangerous situation, or if a dangerous situation arises, please do not try to intervene. The Beacon has security and staff on site at all times that is trained to deal with these types of issues. We do not expect you to handle any crisis. Most issues are dealt with swiftly and there is no need for further actions. However, in the event of a serious issue, please be aware that there's shelter in place and evacuation procedures.
Anytime an emergency plan is activated, a Beacon staff member will inform you over the loudspeaker or in person as to what you should do. If there are dangerous conditions outside and a shelter in place, order is given, please report back here to the training room. Further instructions will be given at that time. If an evacuation is ordered, volunteers will be instructed to muster in the garden located on the Texas Ave side of the building. If that location is deemed hazardous, a staff member will direct you to muster in the courtyard at Christ Church Cathedral located off of Texas Ave, past San Jacinto Street.
Lastly, I hope you all got the message that you can park in our garage. If you did, you will need to get your card validated prior to leaving for the day. Please consult your Beacon staff shift supervisor for your validation prior to exiting the day center. The parking attendants are instructed to make anyone pay for parking if they do not have validation.
All right, it's almost time to serve. Remember that the staff is here to support you. If at any time you do not like what you are doing or you're not receiving fulfillment out of your duties, please let a staff know so that they can work to place you in an area that better fits your personal needs.
More than anything, we want for you to enjoy your visit with us
and have a great time. It's not just about serving, it's about having fun.